They're closing down DJC and elbow strikes. DJC now taking a thrashing at the hands of Zabak. Probably elbow and now feet. See now, quick counter. DJC fighting back. But he's quickly put down again. Vertical silence. Vertical silence locked. But doesn't give up. But Zabak now. DJC, he's got to get something going. Once again, Zabak shutting him down. DJC now misses the elbow. And now, oh my word. Sent for the swing there. And Zabak now. I don't know what the heck he calls this, but now let's counter again. DJC has got to try and oh, that will work. Now, shot there, and once again, DJC is in trouble. He's been shut down nearly every opportunity, and now once again, lyrical silence locked in. And again, DJC in trouble. And wait a minute. A Sonic! Zabak attacked Sonic earlier! And Sonic! Is he out here for... At the moment he's just... See now Zab are telling him to... Daring him to come in, but look behind you! DJC drowned!
1, 2, 3!
And DJC scores the victory!
Here's your winner, DJC!
DJC! In the end, well, Sonic getting payback for earlier, costing Zabak the match. And DJC can certainly feel high. Derek Azika. Zika now! On the assault on the champion! a shot of the ring bell! DJC cut open! He just gets clocked again! DJC takes the Jamaica Plex! Derek Azika! Oh, look at this! DJC's own move used against him! Oh, you see now on top of that table! Ah, the Jamaica Plex! Through the announce table! Derek Azika! Leaves DJC out. Oh, here we go. The tag goal on the line. The Guardians. What a mighty challenge.
This next contest is our main event of the evening, set for one fall, is for the CXWI Tag Team Championships. Introducing first, from Half World, weighing in at 100 pounds, one half of the CXWI Tag Team Champions, Rocket Raccoon.
The Guardians, successful in their defense of Crash and Burn, and now... they must defend the titles again. Rocket Raccoon. He knows full well that this will be a tough task. The new world champion. The CXWI. And of course the leader of the Brotherhood. Here comes the difference maker.
Introducing his tag team partner, also from Half World, standing 7 foot tall, the second half of the CXWI Tag Team Champions, Groot.
As I mentioned earlier, Groot was successful, and KIJW became their world champion, defeating Sully to become the world champion. But here come the challengers. And you can hear the booing. Can you blame the crowd here? Victoria, British Columbia. Here comes the world champion.
Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 255 pounds. Representing the Brotherhood, he is the CXWI world champion. Lester Barkley.
Master Barkley. After what we saw earlier with the what he and Melina did in that graveyard, the graveside of Master Eris. Aqua's master. Destroying his grave.
Introducing his tag team partner from the Cerulean Caves of the Kanto region, weighing in at 330 pounds, is the leader of the Brotherhood, Yuto.
Destroying the grave site of Aqua's master. I mean, I'm disgusted. There's no other way to put it. Here we go, tag titles on the line, and Rocky Raccoon and Lester start the match. And once again, taking out Groot. He's taking out who? I mean, when it comes to Rocky Raccoon and Groot, you know Groot's going to bring the power game. If Lester and Mewtwo can isolate Rocket Raccoon like they did on the EDO when they faced off against Yoshi and Nick Gemini. See now Groot getting in to make the save. As I was saying, we saw Lester and Mewtwo team up on the EDO against the team of Yoshi and Nick Gemini. Nick Gemini wasn't the legal person once in that matchup. The attack was solely focused on Yoshi. And following the matchup, it was revealed that Yoshi has re-exacerbated the broken... You may remember a couple of years ago, Yoshi suffered a broken neck. It was a miracle that he even returned, but it's believed the matchup with Mewtwo and Lester has re-exacerbated that neck injury. Try and give an update as soon as we can in regards to that. Try to cover there, but not even a one. That wouldn't have even been a one, but the ref distracted anyway. Rocket trying to fight Mewtwo off, but there's just way too much power game. But Rocket's still going for it. You see Mewtwo! Hurricane Rana from the top. Rocket still! Still trying. He gets thrown away. Then, oh, there, you see Groot there. Here comes Lester. And once again, they leave Rocket Raccoon isolated. Of course, earlier tonight, Michael Rosa confirmed that Mewtwo would be one of the people in the Beat the Clock. He'll take on Baraka on Crimson. See now, Rocket trying to roll up, but again, not even a one. Rocket Raccoon fighting off. And it, oh, gets blocked there. In front of the corner. And off the pullback in the knee. And again, takes out Groot. Ensuring that Rocket Raccoon remains isolated in the ring. Rocky Raccoon putting up a fight. I don't need to get shut down. Hurricane Rana. Lester and Mewtwo tag made. See now. Uh-oh. Rocket. Hurricane Rana. He's still going on the fight though. Rock and roll up. Up, there's Mewtwo! Quick to silence Rocket Raccoon and Groot now back in trying to get... Trying to get...